Welcome back, everybody, to WWF New York. Don't forget, it's all going to happen in Madison Square Garden for the first time ever. Raw is War in Madison Square Garden on Monday night, September the 22nd. A limited number of good seats are still available. I suggest, folks, you get yours today at Ticketmaster Outlets.
There's going to be a massive over-the-top rope battle royal with a huge list of superstars, with the winner facing the WWF champion for the title at the next Garden event.
And what about the WWF title matchup, Triple Threat Rules? Bret Hart meets The Undertaker and Shawn Michaels, who is standing by with Michael Cole.
Raw's War returns to where it all started, New York City, but this time, Shawn Michaels, it goes to Madison Square Garden. And you're in a triple threat matchup with Bret Hart and The Undertaker. Should be an extraordinary event, to say the least.
Well, of course it's going to be an extraordinary event, because I am in it. You know, I was sitting at home in San Antonio, and my phone rang, and on the other end of the line was Vince McMahon, and he begged and he pleaded, Shawn, he said, we need you to come to Madison Square Garden. Why? Because the fans want you, because I want you, because the only way to make sure that Madison Square Garden is filled to the rafters for Raw is War is to put the Heartbreak Kid on the show. So believe me, New York City, will either you love me or you hate me, you know you're going to come see me. And you know what? You may see me walk out the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
Shawn, what is it about Madison Square Garden in New York City? What brings the Heartbreak Kid to the Garden?
Well, I think it's the love and the admiration of the New York City fans. It's either that or the hate and the loathement of the New York City fans. See, no matter how you slice it, you know where you stand in New York City. They're not wishy-washy, they're not sorta, they're not kinda, they're not iffy. They either love you or they hate you. And to be perfectly honest, I respect that more than somebody who says, I sort of like him, I sort of dislike him. I don't care if you boo or you yay, as long as you're there. And believe me, when the Heartbreak Kid is in town, everybody is always there. Why? It's the place to be. When this cat is rocking the house, everybody knows that everything else is second to the Heartbreak Kid. The number one man in this business is coming to New York City, to Madison Square Garden, to fill it to the rafters, and to give you people a show that you never get to see, except when the Heartbreak Kid is in town.
His opponent, weighing in at 87 pounds, Little Lucky! And we are ready for Minnie's competition one-on-one. Little Lucky to take on El Torito. El Torito weighing in at a whopping 104 pounds. And referee Jack Doan, who's about 5'6", looks like Patrick Ewing in this matchup.
Boy, I got to go back to Shawn Michaels' comments. There's going to be no wishy-washy situation on September 22nd at the Garden. Either he's going to be the champion or he's not. You've got Bret Hart, who everybody knows hates Shawn Michaels. You've got The Undertaker, who has a score to settle and wants revenge, and Shawn Michaels in a triple threat match for the title.
It don't get any bigger than the WWF Championship, and it certainly can't get any more dangerous than a triple threat matchup. It'll all happen in Madison Square Garden 1 week from this very Monday. El Torito. Ooh! And that means Little Bull, James E. Just by the way, he's not a corn chip or something.
I know that. I'm bilingual. I can speak Spanish. As a matter of fact, I'm trilingual.
Oh, are you?
I speak Spanish and English and Oklahoman.
Well, that's quite a gift. And look, El Torito trying to get a little submission here. Get that little submission on Lucky. Never mind. Certainly.
You know, you can make your yuck-yucks and your ha-has, JR, about, you know, they're little and they're cute, and they got little flashy moves, and look at this, back spinning head, wow!
Little Lucky now, he's going to take a chance here.
Wait a minute, he's going up the top rope!
He better be lucky.
Watch it!
Look out, they're right above us, good Lord!
I'm not getting close to these little behemoths. You know what I was about to say was, and that just proves it, these guys are cute and they're small and all that stuff, but they're tremendous athletes. They can wrestle, they're dedicated, and they risk their neck every time out.
El Torito pulling himself back in the ring, and the little bull now ramming Lucky. He wasn't too lucky on that exchange.
Boy, this guy has such a size advantage, and you know, when you're talking about a 20 or 25 pound weight advantage, you're talking about a fourth of these guys' total body weight.
That's exactly right. That's a very good point. And certainly when we have fun with these men, they are somewhat cute, I guess we could say, but they're great athletes, as you pointed out. And certainly we're going to see the pace quicken and get a little bit more intense later here on WWF New York, when the Legion of Doom, folks, they're going to be right here. They're going to take on Farouk and Kama of the Nation of Domination, and that will be a fierce, fierce tag team event here this week on WWF New York.
That'll be brute force and brute force, but you know, when Little Lucky, when he dives off that top rope, it's the equivalent of me or you jumping 25 feet. It's all relative, JR.
Well, I ain't going to be jumping no 25 feet.
Well, I didn't figure you were.
Unless it's into a pile of fried chicken or something. Or maybe a pile of Nathan's hot dogs. Something that I would enjoy lying in, if you know what I mean.
Well, I think we'll get out of that subject, because right now it's a test of strength, and you got to think the big mini is going to, wait a minute, thought he was going to win it, but look at the leverage. And Little Lucky's flying.
Victory roll by Lucky, and a near fall. And El Torito using his power to kick out. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, Goldust and several other top WWF superstars will be making a personal appearance next Saturday at Plaza Auto in Brooklyn. That's next Saturday from 11 until 1. Goldust and many other WWF superstars in Brooklyn at Plaza Auto.
And whoa! If El Torito keeps this up, he's going to butt Little Lucky all the way to Brooklyn. That's really using your head.
You ever been to Brooklyn, Corny?
I have unfortunately been to Brooklyn on one or two occasions.
Uh-oh.
Never on purpose.
Look out here.
Well, wait a minute. He threw him to Doan. Jack Doan.
Jack Doan makes a fair catch, and then El Torito goes straight down. That was the old posterior drop.
I wonder if that was a disqualification. Was it intentional? Uh-oh. Accidental? Torito holds on.
And Lucky now trying to... Uh-oh.
A little fancy footwork.
Moving those feet.
Whoa!
Arm drag takeover into a little crucifix. Jack Doan a little slow getting there, and three, no, and he just got two.
He just got two, he almost had him.
Bad break there for a Little Lucky. Seemingly having El Torito's shoulders down long enough for the count.
Oh, this El Torito really knows how to throw his weight around what there is that exists of it.
Up top now. El Torito. Hey, look, he's going up hot. He's on the top rope. El Torito, look out!
There's no way!
El Torito with a victory over Little Lucky in Mini's action here on WWF New York.
The Minis from south of the border. Always crowd pleasers, and what athletes! El Torito, the winner.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we'll pick up the pace.